Hi there and welcome back to my YouTube channel Bad Book Thief. Asha here. Today I am going to talk about one of these books that was released recently. This book is How to Be a Writer by Ruskin Bond. I am going to talk about this book. I'm going to tell you what it's got for a reader, and I'm going to tell you what I liked about this book and what I felt could have been better. But before we proceed with the review for this book, I want you to please subscribe to my channel. I talk about books here, my favorite authors and stuff like that. So if you do not want to miss out on any of my videos, please do subscribe to the channel. Now, let's begin with the review of How to Be a Writer by Ruskin Bond. This is a beautiful, beautiful book. As you can see the cover, it's got illustrations. It's essentially supposed to be a book for children. But let me tell you that although the cover looks really cute and probably very childish, kiddish, but the content here is useful for anyone who wants to be a writer. Obviously, if you read it at a young age, it's going to be more helpful. But that does not mean that if you read it later in life, it's going to be any less useful to you. How to Be a Writer by Ruskin Bond is a book on the process of writing. It has several sections to it. Sections on why should you write, sections on how should you write, what is a writing style, how do you acquire one, what are the best books one should read, in your journey as a writer or to becoming a famous or a published author. The process of publishing and, how rejections or criticism shouldn't stand in your way of, this creative journey. This book is only about 115-20 odd pages long. I finished it in one sitting because it's got content really beautifully placed. Let me just show this to you. So, as you see, there are beautiful illustrations here all throughout the book on the different sections. Yes, all of these little illustrations. I hope you guys are able to see it clearly. I'm going to just bring it a little closer to the camera so you can see it. So all of these beautiful illustrations make this for a very interesting, engaging read. The content is very nicely placed in the sense that this is not heavy information we are talking about. These are really tips, and Mr. Bond meant it when he said that he is going to share some of his best tips, advice. From his own writing experience. So these are tips really, and it talks about really what this book means to say how to be a writer. So there are sections where we've got to learn about why I write, how do we begin, how do you start, basically how do you prepare, and first steps to publishing, and how to deal with disappointments, rejections, and stuff like that. Mr. Bond here has also shared a list of the best books that you should read from different genres he's read from a very young age. All of these books are some which are really popular, some not much known. I'm sure that as readers, you guys must have already read a few of these books. And for those of you who have not, I think like me, you'll just be very grateful for this list of books. I think the most important takeaway from this book is how you're supposed to find your own voice. You're supposed to find your own style. Find the genre you want to write, and always write in settings you are aware of. In one of the places he shared that he's always written about the mountains because he lives in the mountains and he knows the area so well. So that is something that is absolutely important, I felt, for us to know what we are writing. And if we've stayed in a place and we write about it, that definitely makes the job a lot easier. Very simply, he puts that write the story in your head, write it scene by scene in your head, and then start to get it down on paper, and that way you'll never face writer's block. I felt that was really nice. I think what I really want to also highlight here is this book is not so much about technical information, but more of those constructive things, more of those emotional things that are associated with writing as a process. And if we kind of abide by these rules, so to say, or the advice that the author has to share, it will definitely benefit us in the long run as aspiring writers. Finally, I think all I want to say is if you're somebody who likes to collect books on writing and loves to have them on your shelves, this is a must-have book. You definitely do not want to miss out on this one. And it's a book that you will probably want to go back to every now and then because it's an ageless book and the information, the advice that are shared in here will prove helpful no matter what stage in life you are of the writing process. Do get your hands on this book, which is How to Be a Writer by Ruskin Bond. You're absolutely going to love it. With that, I'm going to end the review here. If you have already read this book, what do you think of it? I felt that this was not meant for children alone. It's for everybody, regardless of the age. And if you feel the same way, do share your thoughts in the comments below. What are some of the other books you've read on writing? Do you want to share, those titles? I think that's all about How to Be a Writer by Ruskin Bond. I'm going to take my leave now. I'll see you in my next video with another book review. Until then, be reading, be inspiring. Goodbye.